Welcome to QuickBooks Online for Nonprofits. My name is Ufuma Ogaga. I am the owner of Goshen Bookkeeping and Consulting. I am a financial controller and a QuickBooks Pro advisor, helping nonprofits to increase profitability one mission at a time. In today's tutorial, I will show you how to create an invoice in QuickBooks Online. Only use the invoice feature in QuickBooks Online to track pledges for your donors if you don't have an external donation system or an external donor database system, or if you are providing a service to your members, such as collecting dues payments, or if you are collecting program fees like a youth fees, or if you are billing your building tenants for renting your facilities. These are the only instances where, as a nonprofit, that you need to use the invoice feature in QuickBooks Online to invoice your customers and request that they pay you at a later time. The account that you use when you invoice and when customer owe you money is actually called accounts receivable. So I'm going to show you how to create an invoice in QuickBooks Online. You're going to click on the Quick Create Plus icon, and you're going to select Invoice under the Customers heading. This is your invoice entry screen. So here you want to choose your member or your donor name. I am going to choose the John Foundation one that we, or the Servant Keeper one that we created before. In the email field, you can enter an email address. You can CC yourself or blind copy yourself. For this invoice, I do recommend blind copying or CCing yourself in all emails, whether it's invoices, whether it's sales receipt that you send out of QuickBooks Online. I'm going to select my invoice terms as net 30 or leave it as net 30. I'm going to enter an invoice date. I'll leave mine as the 27th. QuickBooks Online will automatically calculate the due date based on the invoice terms that you chose. So your due date will automatically be calculated for you. You can manually change that if you want to. I tend to leave it as the default. Since we are tracking out the conditions of our donations and the conditions of our funds, under the division, which is also known as your location tracking, you can select without donor restrictions or with donor restrictions, depending on what kind of fund this is going to be. I'll select without donor restrictions. Under the products and services, and for this particular example, I'm going to try to create a pledge. It doesn't look like I have a pledge service item, so I'm going to create a service item really quick. If you have not watched my products and services video, pause this video right here and go watch that video on how to create service items in QuickBooks Online. So this is how you can enter tithes and offering if you want to, or you could enter pledges. I'm going to enter pledges. I'm just going to leave the category blank for now since it's just an example. I'm just going to select general fund. I am going to change my income account. I'll probably just leave it as is since it's just an example and make this not taxable. And just click save and close. Description field, you can enter the purpose of the invoice. That way the customer or the stakeholder or the member is aware of what this invoice is for. Quantity, leaving that as one. And entering $100 or $1,000 as my pledge amount. Since I chose the class when I created the service item, you will see that QuickBooks has automatically populated the class column for me. If you didn't choose a class previously, you will have to manually select the class in this area. Here, if you are collecting sales tax, that's an option of where you can choose the state that you're collecting sales tax for. You can enter discounts by percent, or you can enter discounts by dollar amounts there. under the message displayed on invoice, this is where you get to enter a nice, simple, short message. It just says, thank you for your business, or thank you for your donation, or thank you for your pledge. Something simple and short. You can also enter like a payment link if you are using PayPal or another third-party merchant processor like Stripe, Venko, all of that. You can put a payment link in this field as well. The message displayed on statements, you can either repeat the same message that you have on the invoice field in that field, or leave it blank since this is an invoice that you're creating. In the attachment section, you can add any attachments that you want to send with this invoice. So if this was a grant and you needed to send like receipts for reimbursement for the grant, use the attachment section to add those receipts. Now at the bottom, you can print and preview the invoice. You can check the box that says print letter to print out a copy of the invoice later. That way you can come back and do that. You can print and preview to just see how the invoice looks like. You can print out a packaging slip. You can make this invoice reoccurring. If this is a reoccurring amount that you constantly charge the same customer every single time, same interval, you can create a template that reoccurs every single time. You can click on the customize option to customize the sales forms. Now, I already did a separate video on how to customize your sales form, so go ahead and pause this video and go watch that video if you have not done so. If you're just creating this and you can save where you are by clicking on the save button, you can click save and send, and QuickBooks will automatically email the invoice to the customer. You can save and close it. You can save and share a link. So QuickBooks will allow you to save it and give you like a short link that you can type up your own personal email and send it to the customer. I am just going to click save and close to complete this invoice. To see a copy of the invoice you just created, click on the sales tab at the left navigation bar and select all sales. Here you're going to click on the open invoices money tab, and there is the servant keeper invoice that we created inside of QuickBooks Online. That is how to create an invoice in QuickBooks Online. Thank you for watching.